So guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to talk about what is a QA analyst, what does he do, what are his responsibilities, how much is he earning, and what is the job market actually saying about the role. And yeah, let's find out. Who is he, right? So let's start off with what is a QA analyst by definition. So their primary role involves testing the software for bugs or defects, or maybe finding other areas for improvement before the initial release to the end user. So a QA analyst also designs test cases, reports and tracks defects, collaborates with developers or maybe other team members, provides feedback on the overall quality or maybe areas for improvements. Additionally, they may also be involved in creating and maintaining test documentation, performing regression testing, and participating overall in the software development lifecycle or maybe different phases even of it. So by definition, this is what it means. And yeah, so now let's find out what is actually a QA analyst's daily responsibilities. What do they look like? Basically, just key points of it. So a QA analyst's daily tasks are test planning, test case design, defect management, like tracking progress of it or maybe moving things along quicker, regression testing, basically executing regression testing, maybe adding more tests to the regression testing. This can be many things. Then after all of that, analyzing all of the test results, compiling them, presenting them to the stakeholders or whoever basically it's necessary. And yeah, and creating and tracking these metrics to see overall how the system is doing and how defects are either growing, increasing, or what else is happening there, just to get better understanding overall of the system's health as well. Test automation is technically named also as one of those things. So they may be helping in automating some tests or writing them or maybe somehow else in this process. Then of course, continuous improvements. This goes for everything, basically providing feedback on any areas that need improvements or maybe implementing them themselves or maybe on the process of testing or maybe something else that is not working. Always just providing some feedback that could help the whole team as well, not just the testing team. So then of course, like communication, documentation, these both things, just documenting maybe the testing process, maybe documenting something about the product that is not anywhere else. Of course, test cases technically is documentation, but maybe something outside of even test cases, something in Confluence maybe. And then of course, exploratory testing and monitoring overall process and results. And then of course, analyzing and monitoring the performance of the product. So overall, these are his daily responsibilities. They're actually very similar to basically what a QA engineer does. If you've seen this video, then you know what I'm talking about. So next point is actually, what does a QA analyst's job descriptions actually say on the internet? So let's jump in and figure that out and see what the job market is saying. Let's jump in and check out the job listings. I have already opened one of them, but I'll make this thing smaller. Okay, so we are going to check out two markets. Let's start with the US market and then we are going to check out European market. Okay, yeah, I have already opened Indeed. It's a well-known basically place to look for work. Yeah, let's just check it out and see if the listings actually match what we found out in the description and the daily responsibilities and duties, okay? So we're just gonna compare like three, maybe two offers and see what they're like. So these are basically the latest ones. And let's start off with this one. Oh wait, there's nothing there. Software QA analyst, let's start with this one. Here it is. Ah, it was lower, sorry. Okay, so the first one, job description, awesome. Okay, so analyze and define system problems. Yep. Define testing standards and solutions by evaluating procedures and processes. Yep. Utilizing advanced test cases, create test plans, scenarios based on business requirements. Yep. Analyze user requirements, procedures, and test standalone client server, web-based and web service applications. Yep. Test, maintain, monitor computer program and computer systems. Document testing procedures and testing standards to help improve computer systems. Work under supervision. That's okay. travel and or relocation to an unanticipated client site throughout USA is required. Interesting. Never seen relocation. Basically what we found out are the daily responsibilities, basically the same thing, except there is like specific client servers on web service applications. So maybe this is a little bit specified job listing, but let's check out the next one. So primary responsibilities, analyze and transform requirements into manual and automated test processes. Work with development team. Yep. Conduct detailed system analysis. Yep. Write, revise, and verify quality standards and test procedures to attain quality software. Developers' processes and procedures to test product requirements, use cases and wireframes in the form of test cases or other documentation. Research market tools and or develop tools required for automated testing. Help to develop and maintain repeatable methods, standards for entire testing process. Coach and mentor developers on testing methodology and best practices. Collaborate with business and technology partners to establish and maintain consistent test methodology and resolve escalated issues during the testing process. Okay, so basically, once again, this is pretty accurate, except that maybe there is more automation testing necessary. Overall, US market, does it match the responsibilities and descriptions that we saw there? Yes, they do. So now we're going to jump into European market. And I took actually German as an example because we are comparing German salaries and like we're using German as European comparison for salaries in my next point. So I thought might as well also check the job listings. And I am going out of breath here talking. But anyways, we're going to check out the QA Analyst application here. And yeah, actually finding some QA analysts in Europe was a little bit harder as they are mainly QA engineers or software testers / QA analysts, as you can see here. So we'll see. It may be a mix of things. But I have already first one open and let's just go through it. So want to become... Okay, this is basically the job descriptions. So first job listing. Maintain high quality of our website, web app, mobile app through testing manual, UI functional and end-to-end testing. Yep. Support the development process by testing new features and using regression testing for each release cycle. Evaluate test results and communicate them to the team of product and development. My English. Identify, investigate, record and track bugs. Write test cases for new features and document product updates. And support in writing and maintaining automation tests. Yes, basically same thing, except once again, yeah, there is automation and it may be a little bit more extensive than maybe I figured. Now let's check out the last one. Well, if we will be able to find one, let's check out this one because it's technically software tester / QA analyst, but it's in German. Let's just use, do we have translate here? Yes, we do. You create test cases, test plans for internal requirements or external specifications on your own responsibility. You carry out this manually and analyze document and test results, create corresponding error reports, bug reports. You develop ideas for test automation and implement them alone or with the team. You develop quality feedback, for example, on usability, and discuss the results, relevant results, with developers and stakeholders. Basically, that is that. And of course, there's some tools that you use, tier like test management tools you use, X-Ray and TestRail, Jira. Yeah, basically, that's a comparison. I would say, actually, like the US side was a bit different than the European side. This is actually very interesting to see. But definitely, like, it's pretty accurate with the job descriptions, except there may be maybe some technical items from automation side there or some project specifics. Now let's jump over to me telling you how much QA analysts actually earn. So the next question is actually how much do they earn? So on average on US, a QA analyst earns between 73,000 $1,000 to $128,000. So on average, it's like 90, 96, if we're being exact. Basically, that's the average. Obviously, it depends which state you are in. Some state may pay you much more than the other. Yeah, so just overall, that's the number. And for the European market, the pay is going to be in euros. The pay, this is taken basically from Germany, Germany's average. Germany has a good IT sort of sphere there as well. It goes between 47,000 euros till 72,000 euros. So on average, 60,000 euros. These are basically the averages. That is what the internet said. Obviously, it fluctuates from companies and so many other things. So this is just the average. What the internet was telling me, how much people are earning. So my summary and thoughts, a little summary just overall of a QA analyst and maybe comparing a little bit on what is a software tester and a QA engineer. As I said, I have a similar video to this. These roles, all three of them are very, very different. And I wouldn't say that one is better than the other. I would say every company obviously has their own needs and they adjust titles and whatnot to whatever they need or they may be looking for. Of course, also, this is what the internet was saying, and then we compared what real life was actually saying. Yeah, those things were a little different, but overall still very similar. You know, I always thought what a QA analyst was, or what was the difference, so it was very interesting to actually going and finding out the definition, specifically what by definition it means. I hope you enjoy my video. Hit the like, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I see you in the next one.